I am fine and hope for the same. It's our second video, Chapter 8, The New School. In first part, we read that Totojen was dismissed from her school, so her mother decided to put her in a new school. The new school was different from other school because it was in the train and the coaches were the classrooms. Totojen wanted to take admission in this school, so she decided to do better in front of the headmaster. In this video, we'll read about the meeting of Totojen and the headmaster. Let us read. Instead of a wall, the school grounds were surrounded by the trees and there were flower beds full of red and yellow flowers. The headmaster's office was not in the railroad car, but it was opposite to the gate of the school. Totojen let go of mother's hand and raced up the steps. Raced up means to run. Then turned around abruptly. Abruptly means suddenly. Almost causing mother to run into her. "What's the matter?" mother asked. Fearing Totojen might have changed her mind about the school. Standing above on the step, Totojen whispered to mother in all seriousness, "The man we are going to see must be a station master." Mother was surprised and said, "Why?" Totojen whispered back, "You said he was a headmaster, but if he owns all these trains, he must be a station master." Mother had to admit it was unusual for a school to make use of old railroad cars, but there was no time to explain. She simply said, "Why don't you ask him yourself? And anyway, what about Daddy? He plays the violin and owns several violins. But that doesn't make our house a violin shop, does it?" "No, it doesn't," Totojen agreed. When Totojen and mother went in, the man in the office got up from his chair. His chair was thin on the top and he had a few teeth missing, but his face was a healthy color. Although he was not very tall, he had solid shoulders and arms and was neatly dressed in a rather shabby black suit. With a hasty bow, Totojen asked him spiritedly. Spiritedly means excitedly. "What are you, a schoolmaster or a station master?" Mother felt ashamed, but before she had time to explain, the teacher laughed and replied, "I'm the headmaster of this school." Totojen was delighted. "Oh, I am so glad," she said, "because I want to ask you a favor. I would like to come to your school." Enough for today, students. In next video, we'll read about the conversation between the headmaster and the Totojen. Thank you and have a nice day.